We've seen in previous videos how important selecting text is. So in this video, we're going to review some different ways of selecting text that you might not have seen or may have forgotten. The most effective way to select a single word in a sentence in your document is to double-click on it. If I want to select the entire sentence, I'll triple-click on it. And to select the entire paragraph, I'll click four times. If I want to select a single row, I can do that from the left margin. I just click down and drag, which is just moving your cursor down or my insert bar. But I can select the entire row using the left side there. And if I want only half a row, I would select from the portion that, from where I want to select from, I'll hold down shift and then click and then hit end. And that selects from where my insertion part point is to the end of that line. We can click where anywhere in the document, and holding down shift and using our arrow keys, there's my down, my up. Holding down the shift, we can use those arrow keys to select. And we also already know that we can just clicking with the mouse and left clicking. We can also use what we selected with the mouse and then fine tune it holding down shift and our arrow keys. So if I wanted to just get the end of the net but not that period, I will use my arrow keys. If I want to select multiple pages, I'm going to start here, and as I go down, it starts speeding down, and it's tough to get exactly what I want. The easiest way to do that is to click where I want to start, put the cursor there using the insertion, and then I'll scroll down to where I want my ending point, and I will hold down shift and click. And that selects exactly what I want without all that craziness in there. Now I want to select out page 2 for some reason or some odd thing like that. To do that, I'm going to the top of page 2. I'm going to hold Control Shift and click Home and then Delete. And now I'll go to the bottom of the page and I would click my insert to the end of my text and hold Control Shift End and delete. And now I only have the one page in there. So a quick way to delete from your insertion point to the beginning or the end of the document. Undo those. A quick way to select the entire document is to use Control A, and if you wanted to copy it all, you would use Control C, and inserting into a new document, I'm going up to here, new text document, and Control V places our entire document into a new Libre text file. I mean, I don't know why you need to do that, discard. But if you wanted to, you can. Most likely you would just save it as the new file name. But if you wanted to select it all, that's a quick and easy way to do it. Now we're going to go over some of the functionality in the status bar. I'm going to select something here. Let's go with that. And where we have the STD standard, I'm clicking it one time. Or I could hold down shift and F8. We'll do the same thing. So I've got my selection, and basically what happens now is when I click, it's like holding down shift, and I can go up to, if I hit escape, you'll see that we return back to standard mode. So it's the same thing as if I select and then I hold down shift. So that's what this standard extend does. Now let's take a look at, we're going to go back to standard and select this again. Extend, we did add. Let's see what add does. Add is basically the same idea as holding down control. And when I hit escape, it returns back to standard. So from here, I am selecting something, then I'm holding down control and selecting. So it kind of adds to the selection having space in between, whereas the shift had to have no space in between, only selecting everything. The last thing on the list is BLK for block, and I can also use Control Shift F8 if I didn't want to use the arrow key on the status bar. But what this does is allows me to select down, and it works a lot better if we have a table in there, and we're going to get into tables in a future video, I promise. But right now we can see that how this works is it allows you to select a group without having to select the entire row, which is pretty handy, and it will be a lot handier when we get into tables.